About to kick off another one.
Yes, sir.
Hurst and Taylor versus Pine and Store. Hurst and Taylor go to 3. Pine and Store go to 4. Did we look? Is this the hot seat match? Winner side, W51. I think it is. Come on, Luke. You're supposed to have this info, man.
I don't got it. I'm slacking.
Where's your hot dog?
I didn't get it.
Why not? You got time. They're warming up.
That's all right. They don't take card. I don't have cash on me.
Bonnie's over there. She got some cash.
I'll be all right. I got a soda.
Yeah. That's a great substitute. but he hungry. I need a soundtrack, dude. I need a board up here. I can just push buttons for sound effects and stuff. I think that'd be so much fun. Somebody misses a shot and you push the button and goes wah, wah, wah. Get some clapping in the background when they make a great shot. This is the 2016 Southwest Regionals. We're in Scottsdale, Arizona at the Wecopa Casino Hotel. It's a pretty cool little place.
Yeah, it's nice.
It's peaceful. Man, did you see the parking lot?
No.
Holy crap, it is full.
No, but it looked like there was a storm coming in, though.
Well, that would be nice. Drop that temperature down.
Looked pretty cloudy earlier.
I don't know how people can live here. It's too hot.
It's way too hot. I was thinking earlier, you know, if we move to Alaska, you can easily start a fire and get warm. But if you're in the middle of the desert, how are you gonna make AC?
Well, take a car door with you so you can roll the window down.
I could make a fire anywhere. I guarantee you. I can get warm, but I can't get cool.
Just take a car door with you so you can roll down the window.
Oh, man.
That's harsh. Yes, this is the hot seat match.
You know it's hot when you go to the Safeway and they have carports to park under.
Now, I'm tell you what, loading in, you got lucky. Show up after all the work's done. Loading in, I drank 5 bottles of water and 4 bottles of Gatorade and didn't have to pee.
Burned it.
Oh, it was brutal. It was brutal. We had a storm come in after we got about halfway unloaded, and luckily the storm came in, and it dropped it down to a balmy 97 degrees. I think we'd all died if that storm didn't come in, give us that break, and cool it off. It was rough. And the coin toss. And the Pine and Store looks like they won the toss.
Well, this guy Racking Adam, he's got a great second ball break. He hits it really well.
This is like his second or third time on the TV table today, so he's doing pretty good.
He's had a singles match earlier. And they squeaked it out. He squeaked the last two out. Hill. Just barely.
Well, we're kicking her off here. Welcome to Bad Boys TV. Looks like we got about 40 viewers. Help spread the word. We're pretty new into the streaming part of the industry. Our videos will go up on CSI, Q Sports International TV. You can always go back and watch there. We'll be doing a lot more events over the next year. Our job is to make Luke internet famous.
Yeah. Yeah, that's going to happen.
Hey, you got the face for a commentator.
Oh, I sure do. The voice, too, right?
That's why I stay behind the camera. Well, interesting. You said he had a great break and...
She broke.
Bernie broke. And did not make nothing.
He's been really crushing that second ball. Every time he's making a ball. And they're spreading everywhere. Well, I like stripes.
Yeah? What are you going to start with?
Well, she can make the 14.
Really?
Yeah. From I'm looking right at the table and she can make it.
Eagle eyes. What I would do to have young eyes again.
They're both not too bad. You could use a 4 to break them out, but that's a tough first shot.
Yeah, I think she's shooting a 4. You shoot the 4 there and you don't use it to break out.
Yeah, that
I think I would have shot the 7.
Best breakout ball you had.
Yeah, I think if you're concerned about making that first shot, I might have shot that 7. You just got to make sure you clear the 4. And if she had shot that with a little bit of high left, I think she could have came down, missed the 4, and then rolled back up for the 6 or 1 or the 4 going towards the cluster. Easy to call it up here.
Yeah, sure is.
Have you missed a shot up here yet?
No, I haven't. Brett has, though.
I think I missed one yesterday.
Brett missed 2 or 3.
Yeah.
His lip's swollen, so he's got an excuse.
Yeah, Brett's having a rough day. All started with you and your your little powder gag.
He sat down last night. Well, he has a rhythm or a routine. Pulls the covers back, sits down, cracks open a drink. And then he grabs his pillow and he kind of, massages it to how he wants it. When he grabbed that, I filled that pillow full of powder. He banged his pillow. And I'm telling you, it looked like if the mattress was on fire or so much powder coming up. And he's like, what is this powder? You're looking at me and I got it all on recording.
Yeah. Well, that might have to go to Facebook.
he's like, the maids put powder on your bed? I said, well, my pillow's
full of baby powder. How did you keep a straight face, dude? I'd have lost it.
I did a pretty good job. He had no idea.
I would have totally lost it.
And then he lays down in it, and I was doing something, and I heard him coughing because there was so much powder in his mouth.
Oh, my God. Well, you better hope he doesn't play as dirty as I do.
Well, this morning we woke up, and I use baby powder all the time. And I said, hey, Brett, you need to use any baby powder? And it dawns on him. He goes, that was you that did that.
Oh, really? Really? He didn't think it was you?
He thought it was the maids, I swear.
Oh, my God.
He had no idea it was me.
I hope he realizes that we can't afford no hotel that powders your bed for you.
The maid had came in to make the bed. And I had caught her in the hallway, and I said, hey, can you change these sheets? I played a prank on my roommate. I put a bunch of baby powder in his bed. And she goes, that's what that was? She goes, I made the bed, and there was powder coming everywhere and, dust.
You better tip that poor girl.
And I told her. That's what I told her. I said, I'm sorry about that. I said, I'll tip you guys before we leave. I'll leave a tip. And she was laughing, though. She thought it was good.
Oh, my God.
I told him I expect full payback. So.
Well, they got some work here. I mean, she can make that, but getting shape on anything down there was going to be a tough chore.
They did this earlier, not these guys particular, but they're trying to run out on a rack that's not runnable.
Well, yeah, I noticed earlier there was a couple matches where both players just came out firing, running, and then they got close, to the end, and they both left themselves in one ball hell. It's like they wanted to run the rack, but they did nothing to get the trouble ball out, and they saved it for the last ball, and it's like, oh, no.
Just because you have more balls than your opponent in the beginning of the rack doesn't do any good. It's how you finish. I mean, once your pawns are gone, like in chess, you're done.
Yeah.
Or at least you're not done, but you lose a lot of power. Control.
Yeah. You got to have a ball that gets you to that trouble ball. Yeah, I saw a player do it earlier. He had ball in hand. He only had one ball in trouble, and he went down to the other end and ran the balls that were wide open. It's like, yeah. Oh, my God, dude, how are you going to get to that trouble ball? And I don't know. I think, you know, for the beginner players, I think it's a mental thing of, hey, you know, I got five balls off the table.
Right, I got two left.
I got the advantage.
Yeah.
But, yeah, it doesn't quite work that way.
No, it's just a game of chess.
So I think if you're new to pool or, you know, a beginner skill level, try playing all the games.
Yep.
One pocket, straight pool, even nine ball. You know, you learn something from each game that will help you with your all-around game.
Especially straight pool when you want to learn eight ball.
Right. And it's funny, you know, a lot of people complain, oh, 7 foot, 7 foot. But I'll tell you what, watch the pros play 8-ball on a 7-footer.
8-ball on a 7-footer is probably the toughest game on the planet.
I love that game.
Besides, like, Chinese 8-ball, you know, those tables are the way the pockets are cut. That's a tough game, but
right.
We don't have that here. Even Shane talks about how his favorite game is bar box 8-ball.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, you got a lot of balls on a small surface, and you got to move around.
Yeah, you got to finesse the rack.
I hate watching 8-ball on a 9-foot.
It's just run out.
There's nothing in the way. It's, yeah. And I kind of, basically, I grew up on 9-footers.
So did I.
You know, I love one pocket. I don't care for straight pool because that's the only game I've ever been mad enough to want to quit playing.
Yeah.
And I was the only one playing.
Yeah, I never got all into straight pull too much. I didn't start getting into one pocket until later, last year or two.
It's a great game. I love one pocket.
It's a thinking man's game, and there's never a same game.
Well, the nice thing is my eyes are getting a little older, and you can play competitive one pocket if you know the moves with a guy that can outshoot you. But, yeah. Watching the pros play 8-ball on a 7-footer is a lot of fun. And it's a good way for lesser players or league players to learn is to watch the pros and see the ball selection or when they play a safe and just how they play the game overall. I don't think that 3 will get by there, but if she can just get it in front of that ball, it's gonna help them out a lot here. Stay in front. That's not too bad. Everybody's got a little work on this table to do.
Yeah. Been a lot of those games here. Looks like Bonnie's got her bag. She's ready to go.
She's tired. Leave
without you, honey.
Yeah, she's tired. As you get older and you move pool tables in and do all this stuff, your body hurts and it's a lot harder to go to sleep.
Yep.
It's not like when you're young and you're just tired and wore out. You just go to sleep. Your body and the aches and pains keep you awake. So then you're just tired every day. But we got a vacation coming after this event, so hopefully she'll get some rest.
Right.
Well, I don't know about you, but yeah, I think he's looking at that the wrong way. I don't know if that 2-5 lines up, goes towards the 3.
He's trying to play that 2 in the side.
Yeah. Let's see here. I think he's in the way of that. Yeah, you can't really tell from there, but boy, that's a tough shot into the side.
Yeah, it is.
And it doesn't really send the cue ball the right direction either.
Well, he almost made it.
Wouldn't
have done him much good.
But now he's got that 14 in front of the 3.
Yeah.
Yeah, he wouldn't have had anything he could do with the rest of the shots there. And that 14 sits there for a nice breakout on the whatever stripe that is next to the 5.
That 12 might go all the way down without having to break it out. Doesn't look so much on the camera, but in person it does.
Okay, we're going to have to get your eyes checked. I'm looking straight down there. That puppy don't go.
Not even rail first, huh?
Nah. It looks like it hit about the end diamond down there on the side rail. Unless you know how to put some curve on that ball, I don't know nothing about. Oh.
Wow, that's hard to do. Miss both those balls.
That is brutal. I don't even have that skill. Those two balls were just barely a ball apart, aren't they? Yeah, he went right between those and back out between those.
You know, she could hit rail first on this 14 and come right into that 5 and still have a shot on the 9, most likely.
Yeah, yeah, that 9 would be a good safety valve. What's she going to do, draw back and leave him a bank? Which isn't a bad idea.
Looks like it.
But I think she left him a bank where he would move that 5, and I'm not sure you want to do that. You got to make sure you get that cue ball so you can make your ball.
Definitely. Bonnie's got the baby powder out.
Uh-oh.
What's she looking to do?
Somebody's going to get in trouble. Well, she's got the first aid kit out. They might be plotting your demise, dude.
Yep. Oh, we barely so missed that.
Yeah. I'm surprised they didn't shoot the 14 and just break those two. I think they had a couple of chances.
I don't even think
they
seen it. Got a bunch of chitter chat on the chat, looks like.
Well, I got people talking. Got all those people in the chat room. How we doing? If the commentating sucks, that's all on Luke. I know I'm entertaining. actually, we should blame it on Brett. He's sitting on the other side of the room now, so.
Yep. Well, that was interesting.
Wow, look how that turned out. That turned out very beneficial. Yep. Yeah, I think you just cut that 12 all the way up into the corner between the 2 and the 5. Try to hit it pocket speed if you miss.
You to the side, though.
Yeah, see, I would go all the way up. Go all the way up.
She's looking all the way up now.
And try to make that. You might make the 3 and then leave them tough if you miss. If not, you might have a nice shot anyway. I might bump that 3 out and still get shape. Yeah, I'm going all the way up. You could end up blocking both balls if you don't make it.
Yeah.
There you go. Look at look.
Made it.
And got shape. Got a decent shot there. Knocked the three away. That's a good shot. Those aren't easy. Well, I'm Rick Jones, and my partner in crime here is Luke Thomas. We are Bad Boys. This is Bad Boys TV. And this is the Southwest Regionals.
Ooh.
In Scottsdale, Arizona.
He struggled with some easy shots last couple matches.
Yeah, and he seems to make great shots.
He makes the real tough ones.
On the tougher ones.
Yeah.
A straight-in shot is not an easy shot, though. If you're off just a hair, it's...
I think if I'm shooting, clipping the two and trying to go behind the five and playing safe.
Yeah, just play a lockup.
You can't try to run this out.
Well, he's going to get behind that eight ball. I think. Yeah, if you leave the shot, though, they're going to leave you tough now. You want to try to get that safety shot in there where the, you know, they can't see the ball at all, and you got a better chance of getting
right
ball in hand. She's banking this one.
Looks like it. Well, they didn't leave them all bad, and their ball's hanging. So.
Well, yeah, that's a nice spot to. If you're gonna miss, that's the way to miss. Miss and leave the ball right in front of the pocket. Well, what do you do here? You just tap that five and try to be behind the eight, or you bank that five with a dead center hit and try to bump that two over towards the pocket? And
you just tap the five, but the problem is you can shoot that ball from almost anywhere off the rail.
Right.
Might even be worth just trying to make the two. Leave yourself tough, long cut on the five. And if you're going to sell out, just go out swinging.
No, that's kind of my theory, but that's why I'm commentating instead of playing in the tournament.
Yeah.
I think, yeah, she's going to call it too. For me, I like the two. I mean, I'd like to shoot that one with high inside and...
You can hit it real good and just miss that side pocket and come three rails.
Yeah, bring that cue ball all the way back around.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I knew you would shoot that. You cut really well. Or at least you used to before you became a bad boy.
She made a good shot. Uh-oh.
Oh. Knock it in.
Yeah, that's no good.
Well, I'll try to get that cue ball over to the right rail, I guess.
You got to bury it to the rail.
It's got to be right on it.
Another option, you could try to bank the five and cover those balls, but.
Oh, yeah. But you have to have played a lot of golf on a snooker table for that.
Yeah.
Because you're sending the cue ball the other direction. What are you going to do now if it goes? Oh, Lordy. Yeah.
She's thinking.
He kind of looked at his partner and was like, hey, I made mine.
Exactly.
He kind of walked by with a little bit of a smile on his face. Yeah, I made mine. What you going to do?
Yeah.
Oh, this is such a tough one. There's a couple things you could do here, though. You could try to thin that 8 and knock that 14 in and leave a cue ball right there. That'd be
an option. 8's not frozen. If you could, even better, just touch the 8 and tuck the cue ball behind it. That's tough.
That's tough, though, because then if you hit it a little too hard and knock the 14 in, they got a straight-in shot. My My vote would be to thin the 8 and knock the 14 in. And then basically leave right. the 8 where it's at and leave the cue ball just a hair to the left of the 14. Yep, right there. And then that's a tough shot. And a tough way to play it safe. You start getting that little ticky-tacky. Yeah. It's hard not to double hit it or push the cue ball. Or you try to shoot it so soft you don't hit a rail. See what happens here. This is a tough shot. And she's going to hit it.
She hit it.
Too hard. Oh. Oh. Wow. Wow. That's just nasty.
That's just dumb luck.
If that ball drops. Wow. That's brutal. You got to hit this one perfect. And even if you do.
They're stripes, though.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So
I don't even. I don't. I just purposely foul.
Yeah.
What are you going to do with the ball in hand?
I can't tell about the angle. Let's look here and see.
You can't do nothing with ball in hand. If anything, just barely bump
you. Are you sure that cue ball won't sit there for a shot in the corner? You want to holler at Brett? Now he can't see. I really don't want to jump down there and ref while I'm commentating.
She's getting him.
Brett thought he was getting a break.
See, I don't like trying to hit this ball. And if you foul, you spread out the eight.
I think you should make Scott Frost ref this shot. But she already got Brett. Brett's going, why don't you guys jump down? And, you know, I know we're a little short on staff, but I think it's a bad idea for the commentators to ref. Oh, come on, Brett. You're blocking my shot. Mm-hmm. Oh, yep.
I would have just purposely fouled.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't think he was. I'm not sure he had enough room to get by there. Yeah, I knew you were going to come over here and look at us. Yeah, I can't do it. I can't do it. I can't commentate and then step out there and ref. Because it's real possible that some people would get the illusion that I'm for one team or the other, and then when I go out and make the call, yeah, I'm not. I can't do it, man. I knew Brett was going to come over and say
something. Oh, yeah.
He's like, man, you're right there. You're the director of referees. Can't you just step out and make a call? No.
He needs a little segue to get around on.
A little referee segue. That would be kind of cool. One day, probably not in my lifetime, but they'll have drones that will go out. And you can just make the calls from wherever you're sitting. Send a drone out to video the shot. Alrighty, so that was Hurst and Taylor that got that got that game. And Luke's over here letting me fall asleep at the wheel on the scorekeeping.
You're in the driver's seat.
Hey, I got it up before the next break, so we're set. Look at this. Two balls on the break and only one above the halfway spot. So here we go. I don't think he has a choice but the six ball. Unless you want to start with a tough cut on that 11.
Right.
Yeah, I'm shooting a 6 myself, I think. Good. And then we'll reevaluate how the table lays out.
Yeah.
Well, which ones do you want from here, Luke?
Solids aren't too bad because that 7 goes.
The 7 goes, and I think the 2 will go up in the upper right.
The 8 will go after the 6 moves.
Um, It's just a matter of when and where you get to those shots.
Yeah, you just got to, you know, you got to finesse this rack just right.
I like the 6-3. If you lose shape on the 2, then shoot the 5-2, follow through, 7, back it up, 8 in the right corner. That's my chaos.
She's going to shoot this ball and try to break something up now, looks like.
And she helped them out.
Yep.
I don't think she helped herself out there. Yep, 14 doesn't go. A 10 might go. I think you can get by that 14 to make the 10.
If he can make that 14 and bump the 9, that'd be good. I don't know if that's possible, though. It's hard to
tell. I don't think he can make the 14, though. I think he's standing right in the way of the view here. Yep. I just looked a second. Yeah, see, unless he takes it off the 10.
Yeah.
Tough spot here. I tell you, I wouldn't be opposed to kicking off the top rail and just hitting that 11 against the rail there. Just playing safe.
Yeah.
Unless he can make the 10 ball. Because I think you shoot this 14 now. If you miss it, you're gonna sell out the table.
He didn't sell out.
No, he got through there. I didn't think he was going to get through there.
Yeah.
And how's that 2-5-6 looking?
Oh, that's possible.
Yeah, that's not really that bad at all. Yeah, he had a tough shot. It's so much easier to call what to do when you're sitting over here.
Sure is.
Especially we're looking at a different angle of the table. I think this is a doable shot. And she's calling a safe. I think that combo is lined up. Or do one of those follow stroke. If it's not lined up, do a follow stroke so the cue ball goes through and knocks a 6 in.
She didn't leave him a whole lot.
Nope. Brett's over there smoozing with Scott Frost. Got a pretty packed room.
Not bad. Oh, wow. It was a nice shot in the side.
Yeah, it was.
I think it went.
Yeah. They might be in pretty good position here, really. Come out and back out there. Don't shoot it too hard. Kind of like that.
Yep.
I'd like to probably try to be short on that so you could shoot the 14 to the side and bring the cue ball right down into the 9 ball.
Send another match over here. Actually, I can send it to make it a switch cameras when this is done. Pick up that one.
We don't have that camera set up. This one's going to probably run until the next round of singles.
I had moved a match for you guys over here.
Yeah, it's probably not going to happen.
We'll see in
30
minutes.
Yeah, this is a hot seat match, dude. They're going to battle it out. Trying to figure out if we can schedule a match on the TV table next or not. Kenny got his first taste of pool tournaments today, of actual playing. Did pretty good for as little as he plays pool.
Yeah, he got pretty excited about it. Well, I guess they shoot the 14 and try to hit the 9.
Yeah, I think you have to now. Yeah, I mean, he might be able to shoot the 13, but that's not going to help him get the 9 out.
No.
Yeah. If she could have got it up a little higher. Cut down on that angle. I think you got to go for it here. If he shoots a 13, the only way he can get to that 9 is to hit it with a lot of high right inside English and hope he kisses off the 3 and shoots a cue ball right at that 7-9. But that's a tall order. You could end up in a whole lot of trouble.
Sure can.
Got to put a stroke on this one. Commit. Right like that. Get back out.
He did pretty good.
He did hit that pretty good.
I don't know. I think the 9 goes by the 7. But she's jacked up on the 13.
Just going all the way up. Gotta make sure you go across the table and back out far enough for the 9 so you don't get hooked behind the 8.
She's trying to shoot inside.
I thought she pointed. Yeah, she pointed. She likes that shot, but I don't think she shot it hard enough.
I don't think she did either.
And judging by the dance, it's gonna be close. I don't think she gave him enough. Well, if you don't have enough, bank it to where she just shot. Because the safety from here is not a good proposition. Well, he must be able to see it.
Wow.
Oh, he had all kinds of room.
There was no worry there.
I don't know what all that head shaking was about.
Maybe he didn't like where the cue ball was going after.
Well, she's got to come with a shot here. Does she call that in the side?
I hope so.
By the way, she's been shooting them up the rail. Bernie shoots pretty straight.
Yep, that's a good shot.
Now we are 1-1. There'll be no easy game in this set. I'll do the scoreboard too, man.
Got
you covered.
All right.
Well, if you're looking for a tournament.
Sorry, go ahead.
Yeah. Here's one you should go to.
That's right.
Your BCA BPL member. Go to badboysbp.com and sign up. All right, what was you saying before I jumped on the
bus? I was
going
to say, I see you got a new truck. New style. Never seen. Never picked
up a
Penske.
Yeah, it drives pretty nice.
Pro Star?
70 miles an hour, too.
70 miles an hour?
Yeah.
That last truck I had in New York did 70.
I will tell you a trick, though.
Is it manual?
No.
Is it an automatic?
Yeah. No, it's not. It's manual, dude. Oh,
okay.
But I'm going to tell you the trick. Cruise control. You got to push the button to turn it on, and it won't work unless you push the brake. Then it will, or the, you know, the engine brake?
Yep.
It won't work going down the hill unless you push the brake. Took me a minute to figure that out. I'm like, hey, engine brake ain't working.
When I got that automatic in Portland, I got in. I felt like I was starting all over again.
Oh, you spoiled brat.
I was like, what do I do? How do I even turn it on? I mean, I don't know how to put it in the gear. I didn't know how to do anything. Automatic semi. Are you kidding me?
I have never driven an automatic semi.
I mean, it was nice. It has the same options as your rig as far as lane stays in the lane. It senses if it gets too close, it backs you off, all that stuff.
Really?
Had everything.
Wow, that's some high-tech truck.
So
it
always
right
kept
there.
Me like two semis a length away at all times with cruise control on.
That's nice. That is an awesome feature.
No matter what. And then if you get too close, one time it scared the crap out of me. All of a sudden it just slammed on the brakes because I got too, like a car pulled into like a center lane to turn lanes
right.
And they thought it was in front of me and it hit the skids.
Yeah, I'm not sure I wanted to do that.
Well, it's not good, especially for like rain and or spraying and snow and ice.
Well, you're supposed to turn off cruise control in rain, buddy.
Well, I know, but I mean, the sensors still catch.
But yeah, that's an awesome feature. When I bought my Prius, he showed me that. I'm like, oh my God, it's so cool. Because I never use cruise control.
And you use it now.
I do.
It just keeps you away from the cars. It's great.
Yeah, I love it. Somebody pulls out in front of me and it slows you down.
Yep, kicks back. You can kick back.
Turn on the turn signal, move over.
Yeah, that truck, I seen it today. I was like, oh, it's a ProStar. Interesting.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a pretty nice truck.
It's probably hard to find a rider out there in Vegas, isn't it?
That's impossible. Yeah, they told me they had a truck, but then they called me back, and they're like, well, it's just a day cab. And I'm like, well, that'll work. And then, yeah, we were doing a maintenance on it. And yeah, you can't drive it nowhere right now. Yeah, it's
I'm
tough
glad you didn't get
a
day cab. Those day cabs are hard for me because I'm so tall.
Oh, they just beat the hell
out
they of me, too.
And I can't stretch back far enough and everything
else.
Yeah. Wham.
I know. The only reason I ever ran a day cab is...
He hit everyone like that.
Yeah. The only reason I ever rent a day cab is just to save money and if it's
It's a short trip, for sure.
Yeah, one time, a rider, we booked a truck and they... Oh, yeah, we'll have one. I went down to pick it up, and the only thing they had was a day cab, and I had to drive a load all the way back to Diamond. I was like, oh, you got to be serious.
That's brutal.
Oh, dude, you think pulling a trailer in a day cab cross country sucks? Wait till you got a bobtail all the way back.
No kidding.
Oh, man. I think I lost 20 pounds just jiggling in the truck.
That's brutal. Well, they got a nice break, nice open table.
Just break out the one right here.
Break out the one. Oh, stay up. Good job.
Well, Scott moved that damn thing in the way. I can't see my crew over there.
Yeah, I know it.
That's a nice feature this year. They got smart and they put a waitress in here.
Yep.
And she's been moving along.
She could pick up
steadily.
Some extra tips that way, too.
Well, yeah. You know, I mean, you're in the middle of a match. You don't got time to go get a drink.
You imagine them doing that in Vegas, bro? That'd make all kinds of
money. Oh, yeah. That would be awesome. Yeah, Bernie's going to have to show him how to shoot those off-angle shots all the way up the table. And I'm just teasing. That's a tough shot. What do you do here? I think you shoot that 13 in the side. And
yep. Side or the corner. But I guess the side. Side, you gotta, you're going to hit the 8 ball, most likely.
Right. Just bump the 8 down the table a little ways, and you got 9, 12. And you could probably even put a little draw in there and just bump that 7 away from the 15 ball. But the 15's pretty much open wide for the corner anyway. Looks like she's going to shoot the 14. This is one of Luke's favorite shots right here.
She hit it good.
I think she hits it better than you do. Oh, no.
She could. They could play that 9 off the 1. It goes down there in the hole.
It might go up in the top left corner, too.
Could, yeah.
Looks like he's going to shoot it towards the 1 ball.
He's got to make the 1.
We got 62 viewers.
We're climbing.
Yeah, climbing slowly.
Friday night.
Welcome to Bad Boys TV. It's sad. The pool world is such an addictive thing.
That's
Friday night and people are sitting at home watching pool on the stream.
Yep.
Yeah, people don't love pool. They're addicted to pool. Bonnie gets so mad at me, we go do 2-3 tournaments in a row or 4 tournaments, we're on the road for 2 months, I go home and watch pool.
Yep.
Drives her insane. She's like, how can you watch pool? We just did 4 or 5 tournaments in a row.
When I was in Turning Stone last week, I'm watching live and I'm streaming the U.S. bar table on my phone in the stands.
That's too funny.
With my headphones on, it's kind of sick.
They need to make some of those virtual glasses that we should be able to stream in virtual pool. But, you know, when you go into a sports book at a casino and they got all those TVs, that would be so cool to see 5 or 6 or 7 different pool tournaments all going at once.
Right.
It'd happen.
Mm-hmm.
There's a ton of streamers popping up out there and
singles players are rolling in, aren't they?
Yep. The ladies start tomorrow morning. And the team start Sunday morning. And she's shooting that on the side. That touch.
Pretty good.
And she held the cue ball on that side of the table, so her partner's got the 4.
4 or maybe the 6, I don't know though.
Yeah.
Don't look like he can shoot it.
No. No, I'm not sure what they're going to do with that 6 ball.
Yeah. He wants to play on that table.
Yeah, it's a packed house. He probably wants to get ready for his next match. When the team start, we'll have a camera pointing at each table so we can get both sides. Well, what do you try here, Luke?
Cross cut the six and cross bank the six into the side.
Did he have enough for that?
Oh yeah, he's got enough for that. Plenty. He's looking at it. Problem is, this 12 is a big ball.
It's a huge.
He's gonna hit it going in or coming out, one or the other.
If you can get around it.
Well, he would have hit it if he'd have made it.
Yeah, if you could get around it, you're still gonna have a tough shot on that six. That was a tall order there.
Yeah, it was.
I was thinking maybe you shoot the four in the corner and just draw that cue ball back so the eight's not blocking it to the six, but then you're going to bank that six cross corner. I'm not even sure Earl with his butt weights could have got shape on that six.
Yeah. Or a super glove.
Oh, dude. I was crying.
His glove on steroids.
I'm running the bar table watching Turning Stone. And out of the corner of my eye, I saw Earl walking around the table with this big bag of whatever on the, like he was wearing a huge fanny pack.
On his back, yeah.
Yeah, I was like, oh my God, what the heck? Joe Rogan got it right. How about Karen Cora finishing second?
She played so good. She's got so much heart and grit. She came from behind on a couple of matches. And she just don't quit.
It was awesome. And props to her to play with the fellas.
Yeah. That's her best finish on that tour.
That's a strong field, too.
Yeah.
You don't get to the finals by luck. You gotta play. Those guys, a lot of those players, out of the 128 field. Yeah, that's a strong field.
Yeah. Jason's playing pretty good right now. It's going to be an interesting U.S. Open this year.
Boy, you know, Jason just dominates that event. What is that, his fourth win? Four out of five.
Yeah. Mika won the one in January. He won the three before.
Yeah, that's strong. Anytime you can win an event that many times.
For sure. Wow, great shot.
Oh. Get up a little. That's not.
It's all right.
Not too bad. Well, she stroked that in there pretty strong.
She did.
I see a lot of people look at this shot and they don't even consider cutting it in the corner. It's like they feel like it's too far away.
Yeah, it's cuttable for sure.
Yeah, see, he's going. I think he just called it up in the far corner.
You banking it?
I think he's trying to cut it all the way up the table. Oh. You got to walk around the table and look at the shots, because I think he could have cut it right here in the bottom right.
I think so, too.
Walk around, take a look. I think that was way easier than the shot he just tried. Careful not to get behind that eight on this one.
Watch the scratch. No?
Yeah, she pulled it back quite a way.
Well, you got to shoot this in the right corner, I think.
And three rail your way out?
Three or two. You can do two rails center table.
Yeah, I'm watching this guy shoot. I think it'll be a three rail.
Good thing about shooting in the right corner, if you hit it a little too thick, that 12 big.
Yeah, just double the size of your pocket.
It bad, yeah, it makes it a lot bigger.
I like the way you're thinking.
Well, you
gotta
hit,
the last thing you want to do is cut it, undercut it.
Yeah.
Well, cut it too thin.
I play safe here. I try to thin that 12 and come up by the other side pocket.
Yeah, she shoots pretty strong, though.
She might just bank
that back. And
even if she banks it, she's not going to leave too much unless she hits it too hard.
Right. Just block that pocket.
Yeah, block the pocket and leave the cue ball in the side rail.
And if she shoots at pocket speed, that cue ball.
Yeah.
Should be right about where you want it. The way she stroked in that last shot. Let's see what happens. Oh, too
she
hard.
Hit way too
and
hard.
Way bad.
Yeah, you gotta kind of play a two-way there. Mostly control your rock.
Yeah, well, she overcut it big time. I think it hit the rail before the side pocket.
Yeah.
That's tough when you're stretched across the table like that. You don't have your bridge and stroke lined up the way you normally do.
Things are pretty dang good if you want one.
I'm good, man. Appreciate it, though. I'm afraid to open it. There might be a powder bomb in there. Between powdered beds and frogs you can lick, it's been an interesting week.
Was your spider back this year?
No, but Delina said she saw one out. They went out walking the other day and she saw one. Yeah, they can stay out there. Tarantulas or, yeah.
He drained it.
And they'll take a 2-1 lead. And it's a race to 2. Hurst and Taylor are only going to 3. Pine and Store are going to 4. I don't know if you say that Payan or.
I think it's, yeah, Payan or Payan or something.
Payan.
Payan.
Somebody said leave her all alone.
Really?
I've watched Earl play my whole life. I find it amusing.
Cheap comedy.
Go online and watch where Joe Rogan does an impression of Earl because he talks about ass weights. And when I, some of his little things, he might have some points on, but I'm not buying the ass weights. I can't do it.
He sure gave Mike Duchesne a hard time in their match.
Did he?
Yeah, mentally and everything. They were having battles. There was a crowd. Crowd was cracking up.
Yeah.
Mike was having his issues with the rack, and Earl was just going off. Earl's teaching him how to rack, and he was just the little things he was doing to Mike. It was hilarious.
Earl can be very entertaining.
Tell you what.
And then Earl can also step over.
He played good that tournament, though.
Yeah.
I watched a few matches. He was just running out from everywhere.
You know, there's no doubt the guy is one of the best nine ball players to ever play the game. And he's no slouch in any of the other games either. If he could just mentally.
If he had like Shane's mental right now, he'd be unstoppable.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
He's got all the physical ability that anybody could ever ask
for. Sure. Sure.
I mean,
the guy just, he can play.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody's got to figure out a way to balance his head. Yeah, I wouldn't bet against him if you know, and there have been times where you go to a tournament and Earl's been calm and it's like, hey, he's going to play good.
Yep.
You know, but, and there's a bunch of players like that that.
Not quite to his talent level.
No, not though. To that extreme or not with that talent. But there's a lot of talented players out there that you watch in a tournament and you can almost see them uncork.
Yep.
Yeah, if you go back and watch some of Earl's best matches, oh, my God, the guy could get out from anywhere.
Mm-hmm. He makes it look so easy.
Yep, his ball speed was phenomenal. If you ever want to see some great pool, watch the match where they Earl and Efren played for $100,000. That is some of the greatest pool. But just turn it off with the last, 20 games left? Because something just snapped with Earl, and he just started getting every game it seemed like he just got a little edgier, and then he started making mistakes. And but up until that point, that's some of the best nine ball I think I've ever seen. That was a nice shot right there. I didn't think you had room to get by that three ball.
Yeah, I don't know what he's going to do with the 13, though. They're burying a hole again.
Yeah, you got to get yourself in trouble if you wait till the last minute to get those tough balls out.
Yeah. She's trying to look in at playing the 13 off the one, but I don't think it's possible. It's just if she if the key 13's just gonna 13's just gonna lock up. It's gonna hit the rail, hit the one, and then stop. I don't. She might have enough angle, but I don't think so.
No, but she's got it in front, so. Make the other team do the work.
Where's this food delivery we're supposed to get?
I don't know. I think that's what, dude, somebody put the wall up so they can't see us and we can't see them. They might be over there eating steak or something.
They're over there chowing down, aren't they?
Yeah. Yeah. Let's see how they treat us.
She gonna make a 13? Good shot. That's an 8-ball shot.
Yeah, that was a smart play. Bernie's not new to this game.
No.
She knows what she's doing. That was pretty smart. Did that 10-ball go by there?
If it is, it's called. He might be no. He was trying to shoot the 11.
What?
And he hit the 4 for it was a foul. Wow. I don't know if he's going to call it on himself, but it was a foul.
I don't see how he thought he could shoot the 11.
He hit the 4 first.
You know what I like about this YouTube stuff is I can back it up. Confused. He totally missed the fact that there was a foul.
Yeah, you'll see.
Yeah, I'm surprised they didn't see.
See?
Yeah, I'm not sure what he was trying to do there, but yeah, it looked to me like he hit that four first. Well, maybe they didn't see it that way. I mean, we're at a different angle. They were all standing pretty close to it. So. Now, everything is wide open.
Yeah, I look for them to get out here. There's no problem.
Yeah. Now, I'm shooting a five here.
Yeah. Definitely not shooting this four like he's looking at.
No, I'm shooting that five.
Because if he hits it, you know, too thin, it hits come off the 14 dude, or does something miscues here.
I mean, it'll work, but I would much rather shoot that five. Oh, that was – that's luck.
Yeah, he wasn't
that shape is luck.
He wasn't playing that.
I think you – shoot. Yeah, it worked, so I guess.
That was one of those shots where all I got to do is make this, I'm going to have a shot somewhere.
Yeah, I mean, you shoot the five with a stop shot. It slides over. You got the seven. You got the one. You got the three. The four that he shot was you can make from anywhere.
Yep.
That was too risky. He hits that a little bad, and he's in the side pocket, or he's froze up against the ball. It worked. Yep. So who am I to complain? I guarantee if I'd have tried that.
But I'm scratching the side, cross side.
I'd have done something bad. I'd have got a bad roll. And I would have deserved it. But he was fortunate. It worked.
Speed.
Yeah.
You could play a stop shot or come to the end rail and bump back off.
Looks like he's planning on rolling down and up. Inside English.
Huh.
Yeah.
Maybe a little harder than he had to.
Not sure why you put all that force on that. I mean, he could have just went with regular English and cue ball rolls up between the 8 and the 10 and shoot it in the same pocket. Anytime you start forcing the cue ball to do physics that aren't natural, you're risking missing or
doing that.
I think she got a pretty fortunate roll, unless that 10-11 is lined up perfect. But yeah, I think he worked too hard to get shape he didn't need to get.
Yeah.
Well, this is not the shot you want to have to face when your opponents have the eight ball in the jaws.
Nope.
That's a tough shot.
It is. Pretty much game over.
Yeah. I learned my lesson earlier. Guy breaking runs, makes three incredible shots, has a straight in eight, and I said, okay, well, the next game. And then he misses the eight. It's like, are you kidding me?
Oh, they are on the hill. I'm going to step away to the restroom real quick.
All righty, man. I think I can handle it for a bit.
All right.
This is Bad Boys TV. We are at the Southwest Regionals in Scottsdale, Arizona. At the Wekopaw Hotel and Casino. It's a pretty nice little place. Thank you. Looks like we have about 62 viewers. Welcome to the show. We appreciate you watching. Hope you help spread the word. Bad Boys TV is pretty new to the industry. We set up and run tournaments all over the country and a few in Canada. We decided since we were at the tournament, we'd go ahead and stream them too. How can you not join the Bad Boys Club? If you're looking for a tournament to do later in the year, October 31st to November 6th, we are at the Mayborn Center in Temple, Texas. BCAPL players, USAPL players. You can sign up at badboysbp.com. And it looks like everybody's back from the bathroom.
Well, they're over there chowing down on nachos.
Are they really?
Yeah.
All of them over there?
Yeah.
And dogs. Might have to make Brett do the next match all by himself. Tell you what, dude, I love that deep fried avocado.
Pretty good stuff.
Oh my god, that was good. I'm hooked. Got a new thing to add to the menu at home. I saw it on the menu and I was kind of hesitant. I'm like, really? How do you deep fry an avocado?
Yeah.
But I gave it a shot. And now I'm hooked. All right.
Well, they're on the hill.
Playing in stores on the hill.
See, they don't have to. They think they have to change breakers, don't they? They don't have to.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
She
got one in. And, looks like they'll shoot solids.
Yeah. Stripes look better, but.
I don't think they have one they can shoot at. I really wouldn't want the solids unless I could get a nice little breakout right here. Which I think he has the angle.
He got a little bit out, but there's not. He's got a lot of work to do still.
Two out of three out of there. And I don't think he left her anything. That's kind of my straight pool game right there. So I don't play it very often.
Well, she fired that in.
Jeez. Well. Who needs shape when you can bank like that?
Yeah.
That was a nice shot. There's still no easy shot on the table.
No, and the eight ball's tied up. Five ball's tied up. Three doesn't really seem to have a pocket, but it might go past the 10.
Six ball, you might be able to take off the rail, off the five. Can't tell. Looks like he might have that angle, or might be able to go off the six and the cue ball into the five. Yep, whoa. Just like that.
Yeah, you're kidding.
That was pretty nice. Now the tricky shot. You cut the six in. You gotta not hit that 11 on the other side of the table. Does that three go by the 10? I don't think it does.
I don't think it does. I think it did before he moved that ball.
Yeah, I think now you cut that two to the left top corner. and hopefully give him a shot on the six so that he can come down. Yeah, that's with that eight sitting right there. That's not easy either. Of course, the way she banks, she might be able to just shoot the six, stop, and bank the three across.
Yeah, she fired again.
She did. She lit that ball up.
Good shot.
Hold on, man. Hold on. Well, he might be able to get her shape.
Problem is, where are they going to shoot the eight?
Well, you know what? They can shoot this six and come down just off the side rail and off the 14. She could shoot that three all the way to the top left corner. And possibly get him shaped to shoot the eight all the way up the right corner.
Yeah.
He's looking at the three by the 10, but I'm pretty sure that doesn't go. I think you just shoot this with a little bit of high right-hand English to cube off the side rail, about the second diamond there, and bring it on down. Off the top edge of that 14. I think you can get it over there far enough for her to shoot up in the top left corner. Just my opinion. She's over there telling him what to do. Bernie's got a lot of spirit. She might have just told him, hey, just make sure I can see the ball.
Good chance of that.
Yeah, I don't think he had to try that hard. I think just pocket it and just bring the cue ball over, you know, halfway between that first and center diamond. I think he was trying too hard to do a lot more with it. Yeah, I don't think he was real confident with it either because his stroke really was a little bouncy on that one. But Hurst and Taylor got some work to do here. I like shooting the 11 here. Just take the cue ball across the table between the 13 and
yeah, just if you leave center 12 table, you over leave yourself there. A lot of options.
Yeah, yeah.
Playing safe here, just tapping this, or is he going to make this ball?
Well, I was trying to look at that to see if it was the way he's shooting it. I think he's just okay. looked to me like he was aiming for a draw or a stop shot, and then he followed it.
Hard to tell what was going on there. But this is he's got a good angle to leave her good angle on the six, but I don't know why he's putting so much inside on it. He needs to try to hit that 15. Oh. Okay. Was he meaning to do that?
I thought he had room to just cut that over there. Well, he's got to just take it easy here. Don't shoot this shot too hard or too soft. I think right here you just shoot that 14 and pop the cue ball off the rail a little bit. Let her shoot the 10 and come out around between the 15 and the 12. And if you got a good shot on the 15, shoot it and then the 12. See, they're kind of going a little bit backwards here.
Yeah, I'd be shooting the 14 for sure first.
Right, because now.
It'll still work.
It'll still work.
They want to shoot the 15, but it just doesn't seem as natural this way.
Right. Got to work it a little bit more this way, I think. Don't want to get the cue ball too close to the rail, or well, you could freeze it to the rail and it'd be okay because 14's off the rail, but you definitely don't want to end up too short and leaving straight in.
Yep. Roll three on the side.
Yeah, I think she was a lot more concerned about the shape and just took her eyes off the shot a little bit there. This is where Bernie really comes to it. She shoots these shots really well. We got 64 viewers. Welcome to Bad Boys TV. I think Luke's over here falling asleep on me.
No, I'm not too tired.
Well, you shouldn't be. You took like a month off.
Need a little food in my system, though, I think.
I know, yeah.
That's the most I think I need.
Tempted to go get some filet mignon or something and eat in front of them. Nice shot by Adam.
That was a nice stroke. This should... She shouldn't have any problem with this.
No. And that's the first time in the last three or four shots that Adam looked comfortable and he shot right. It, you know.
It was in his wheelhouse, apparently.
Yeah. Well, you know, when you're on the hill and you're about to finish off your opponent.
Ooh.
She scooched that one in.
Sweep the match, 4-1.
And there you go. I'm sure we will have another match coming up, I think, 10 o'clock, I think. You want to check out CTS on demand, or you can go to badboysbp.com, click on the brackets. You can bring up this event and when we schedule a match on there to be table one. We'll be back to you shortly.
Thanks, everybody. We almost hit 70 viewers.